best players in the sport coming together to celebrate it.
Two balls and a strike to him. Here it comes. Runner goes from first to swing and a miss. Ooh, and Heim tried to stop the throw. Instead, it squeezed out of his hand. The throw back to him, and they get him. Caballero gunned out at the plate on an oopsie.
Put it in the playbook. Make it a new play going forward. This is amazing to see from
Manoah. Set, kicks and deals. And a bunt, third base side. Hugging the line, rolling, twisting towards the chalk, hugging the, and Manoah gets down on his knees and tries to blow the baseball to no avail. But how about this? Jeremy Pena dropping the bunt down to the third base side.
And I know that Alek Manoah, he's trying to blow the ball into foul territory, right? That's funny. He's trying to be relaxed.
See if he got it. Hit it pretty well. Renfro with some serious power. Is it enough? The play is made. Nope. Excuse me. It is not. Where's the baseball? It's all. Oh, it's lodged in the fence.
In the padding, yeah.
Okay. It's lodged in the fence.
So it'll be a double.
Yes, it will. So who's going to go out there and get it? You know how in the, you know, off the wall and then just lodges in there. Somebody tall enough to go out there, jump and kind of pop it off the rim. You know, get it back in play.
Yeah.
Tapper, Otani will take it on the line himself, and he'll wait for Tucker. Says, basically, hands his palm over so that Otani could tag him.
Just saying, yeah, you got me this time. High five.
Popped up, foul ground, long run for Machado, trying the over the shoulder, and he catches it. A bobble or two, but he makes the catch.
Oh, I hope
Manny,
he's okay.
Machado over the shoulder makes the grab a couple of times.
That is one of the most incredible plays that you'll ever see. The juggling act, the glove, keep it up in the air, time it perfectly, catches it barehanded. Manny Machado, you are all over the place.
To left field. It's sinking, and that'll drop in front of Duran. Veerling getting greedy. He wants two. Goes around the tag and he's in there. He can hit and he can swim on dirt, I guess, a little bit, huh?
Yeah, that was an excellent athletic move there by Veerling at second.
Pitch, squares to bunt. Did not go.
Ball just went under his foot.
I was going to say, I thought it may have grazed his foot.
Watch this. I think he picks up his foot and it goes under. Or between them.
Between
the legs.
The five hole. Look at Charlie's reaction.
He's thinking, how the heck did that not hit him?
Alejandro Kirk, the batter, as McGill picks off Varsho. Nice move by McGill. They've got him in a rundown now.
They're going to get him now. Oh, it didn't tag him.
Did he get him? He got him.
Oh, my gosh. They almost botched that. Wow. That was not how you run a proper rundown. And look at Buck. He almost, oh, they caught him in a trying to steal. Okay, so it's 1-3, 6-3, 4, and we'll stay with 4. That's too many. Oh my gosh, they almost blew it.
Just barely scraped the back.
The 2-2. That's a pop up on the infield. Who wants it? Schmidt hustling in from third, and he dropped it. And then Judas picked it up and threw it away. Goodness, Betts is good. Now the Dodgers will have two at third. Yastrzemski throws to Crawford. They've got Mookie in a rundown. They're going to throw home. Patrick Bailey will flip to Junis, who tags out Bush. Betts ends up at third, and that's one of the craziest plays.
lack of velocity.
Runner takes off, and that ball is going to be chopped through the open right side. Margot's going to go to third. They're going to wave him around. The throw comes back to the infield. The runner has scored. Now the throw back into second base goes into center field, and that's going to give Diaz an opportunity, and he will circle the bases and score standing up. How about that? First, and Yandy circled the bases standing up.
Well, right here, you get aggressive right here, Brady Williams with the send. And the ball was coming in to the infield, had to be redirected to the plate. It was wide. That throw was wide, and nobody's home because everybody was going after the Yandy Diaz hit. So that ball rolls out into center field, had to be chased down. Yandy could have walked in.
The Angels are going to have to pile up some wins. There's some animal on the field.
Well, the rally cat.
Look at that. Yeah, get out of there.
Rally cat.
Oh, man.
Uh-oh. How does the cat even get in the stadium?
I don't know. Where's Heidi? Go interview the cat.
You saw what happened in St. Louis a couple years ago. That cat was, as the young people say, about that life.
Are we cueing the music?
Let's
man?
Hit it. It's time now for the best of the worst, or the worst of the best, the not top plays of the week, number 10, A's Marlins. A's are sort of a not top franchise.
Oh.
But Sandy Alcantara, rather, tries to pick off Ramon Laureano. There's just, you know, throwing it to absolutely no one.
You might be asking yourself, Ramon Cobb, any relation? No, his dad did not invent the Cobb salad.
Wouldn't be talking to you if he was.
That was Bob Cobb.
Number 8, Bob Cobb.
True story.
Rays and Red Sox. Rafael Devers.
But don't tell that to the fans. Roman candles need not apply. M80s are higher.
Oh, my word. Number 6, Cards, Rangers.
Yeah, those are fireworks.
This is Nolan Gorman. He's just trying to get a little too fancy. Got a no look behind the back. Mm-mm. That's when keeping it real goes wrong. Cardinals, Kentucky would win, though, 16-6.
To the professional ranks, Redbirds taking on the Rangers, top of the 8th. 2 on for Nolan Arenado. This is going deep left, all right, off the wall, and we just have chaos on the base paths. All right.
What is happening?
You don't even need the spot shadows to know that my guys are running amok. All right, we are caught in a pickle. Arenado in safely at third. Oh, it's about that time for the not top of the week. You hear the music, you're about to see the sounds. You're not going to see the sounds. We showed this guy earlier, the Rays ball boy.
Yeah.
Took a spill right there. That was not top play material.
Take a spill, you say.
But then, yeah, you know, there might have been an accident in the studio earlier. Rangers bullpen giving him the business. He did redeem himself, though.
He did. Yeah, he had like a top play in addition. So, yeah. All right, White Sox and the Marlins. Top 9 bases loaded, and Tim Anderson tries to come, and it just tries to come home and cut off the run. It's a bobble, 5-run 9th. Oh.
This is Angels pregame. Joey Ohtani.
Oh.
He's going around through the dugout slapping his teammates like, hey, give me some help today. I can't be the only one with offense.
God.
So he's just slapping everybody.
Don't call it steroids?
No, we do, but yeah. I don't know if
Jokic.
I don't know if Jokic wants to sell you. Oh, he has Thor's hammer. No longer. People, if you're watching, a few times in your life, you will be equipped with the hammer.
Hey, Pippen teammate on teammate crime is going on.
Phillies, Diamondbacks, runners on the corner, one out for the Phils. Cody Clemens pops one up to left. Corbin Carroll. Can I sing to you? Forgets how many outs there are, which is going to allow JT Realmuto to score. What are you going to do?
That dude on TikTok who just goes up to random women and is playing
just
the guitar.
Flexing his shoulders.
I wrote this song.
Can I sing to you?
Can I sing to you?
Don't let your girl see this.
Siwon Bay laying down the safety. I love it when Bay lays down a squeeze. And then Eduardo Escobar throws it away. Oh.
Staple of Friday. It's the not top plays of the week. Number 10, A's and Guardians. Ramon Laureano has trouble scooping up this single in the outfield. So I'm going to get it. I got it. And uh-oh, where's the baseball? Cleats digging into the grass and nearly falls down. All the runs.
Thousands. LSU ran away.
Crazy.
With that.
Number 8 Yankees pregame. Victor Wembanyama in town for the draft. That's why he's playing basketball, y'all. Because that's just a bit outside.
It's a web gem.
It's too. Baseball's too small for his hand.
It is, man. It's
like throwing a marble.
Oh, gosh.
Or a pea.
All right, number 7, Yankees, Red Sox. We're moving it to Fenway here. Gleyber Torres just attacks the ball. like orcas are attacking boats these days, but he kind of just gets a little squirrely with it. Anthony, yeah, not too great.
Why not? Number six, June 6th, Mets and Braves. Eddie Rosario to left field. Jeff McNeil, he tries to field it, but see, I can't. Someone put some stuff on this. I can't pick the ball up. Drops it three times before he's like, that's going to be on the Stanford. Walks it off. I feel so bad for that young man.
This was Father's Day, June 18th. Our guy Jamai Webster helped save the day after this happened here. All right, this Pops had a tough one. Just, you know, bringing the kids to the ball game, creating core memories.
Big bro is so mad.
Hey, look, they made out, though. They made out like champs.
By me in the clubhouse today, and I said, what's on your necklace? Is that a tooth? And he said, yeah, it's a tooth. My mom told me to wear it. It's his grandma Anna's tooth.
What?
And he said, whatever my mom tells me to do, I'm going to do.
I've seen a shark tooth on some people's necklace, but never a human tooth.
We're going to have to do some post-game digging.
Running again. Ball four. Having some fun with Lindor. So back-to-back walks for Carrasco.
Well, it was dog day here at the ballpark, and some of our canine friends, we love them all. Big, small, fluffy, short hair, we love them all. And they took the grand tour around the ballpark. Some got to ride.
Yeah, it's a good day. It's a celebration of man's best friend.
Well, that's when you know that it's 8-1 in the eighth inning. Sandcastles.
Too much time on my hands. That's about as close to the beach as you get as a Major League Baseball player in the summertime.
Well, we are right next to Lake Michigan. Let's really put some thought into this.
I think the cameraman right behind him might argue with you. Hey, could you move?
You're in my shot. Doesn't seem to be a grand design plan here. If he gets out there with one of those plastic buckets and a spoon, we'll know we're in trouble.
It's a real-life version of Sim City. You build your own little village.
Tell you what, if he had done that prior to the sausage race, it could have been a disaster.
Oh,
be cased meats all over the field. And a seat on top of everyone.
There you go.
That's nice. Nice touch.
Nice finishing touch.
Well, got him for a double his first time back in the first inning. And he hits this one up the middle. That's a base hit. He likes to run. Lowe will pull up with the single, though, this time. And the brothers will spend a little quality time at first. Josh, like the little brother, just trying to annoy big brother.
Well, you don't have to wait for Independence Day, folks. A little impromptu hot dog eating contest. Section 218 or 212, it looks like. I do not think we're going to have a Joey Chestnut sighting.
No.
Give me an idea of what it was like just to get the early lead as you get down here.
Why is it so big? Why is your cup? Is it
get it over with. You're going to get other people wet.
Thank you for covering the mic too, Trey.
Yeah. Because
it is.
God dang.
Whoa. Hello, man. It's pay for that seat.
Yeah.
See? Can you? I guess you can. There are cutouts there, right?
Lipsky loses the bat,
trying to hit that fastball, and it went to the far end of the Mets dugout. He went. He hit to the right side. You can never take anything for granted. And Greg Kessinger.
Oh, took him out.
Took out his pitcher, Brandon Pelech, by sliding to the bag. I think if it was a normal runner, he would have just flipped it to him. But with how fast De La Cruz is, Greg didn't want to take any chances.
That's a great play.
Well, it's a great play. Minimal spillage. That should be taken note. Very minimal spillage. You just got to do what you got
to
do.
There's a balloon that has made its way to the outfield that is causing a problem.
Up first.
So that won't be a problem anymore.
Yeah. That's one way of getting rid of the balloon, right?
Number seven took a beating there on that foul ball.
Uh-oh.
He's getting booed. Torkelson's getting booed at the bottom of the seventh. You don't do that to number seven around here.
He's got to be a little more agile than that, right? He just flipped it over there. Come on, you're an athlete. You're a play with athletes.
How many times did you want to do that to an umpire?
Bob? Every time. Every time.
On in foul territory. Drop it. He got a glove on it.
It's a play that Andrew normally makes. Marcano, a slip, and now he's going to kick at the ball out of his glove. He slipped.
He charges, he gets around it, and that foot just kind of gets away from him as he slides down, and at that point, there's nothing he can do.
Yeah, that was good.
Get the last drop.
He's a last drop guy.
Look out, the baseball bat went flying.
Nice toss right there. Exit velocity, not so much, but launch angle not bad.
It's up down that camera well there. We break a lens? Oh, we sure did.
Oh, yeah. That's an expensive foul ball there.